Okay, today I want to show you how you can create a basic cloud material in Reality Composer Pro using some fractal noise in a shader. So we're going to drop a basic sphere into our scene, scale it up a little bit, and we're going to create a new material and apply it to our sphere. And in our material, we have this basic preview surface, and we're going to be using a fractal noise 3D node. So if I were to just plug this right away into the color, just so we get this kind of rainbow color effect, but we're not actually gonna be using the noise directly per color. Instead, I'm gonna bring in a mix, and this is gonna mix two colors together. In the foreground, we're gonna have white. That's gonna be our clouds. And then the background is going to be our sky blue color. So plug this into our color channel. And if we were to mix this as is, 0 to 1, so 0.5 would be half, we're just gonna see basically a grayish blue mix of those two colors. What we actually wanna do is use that fractal noise we created to control the mixture. And now this is gonna give us some variation so the mixture is different across the sphere. Now, one thing I'm going to do is drop in an absolute node. This is going to make sure that our noise values stay in the range of 0 to 1, so we don't have any negative values that would give us some unexpected behavior. If we look at the fractal noise node, there's some different parameters, and the best way to understand these is really just to play with them. You know, you can increase the octaves and see what effect that has, and basically just play with these different parameters until you get something that you like. Now, clouds move, so we're going to drop a time node into our graph. We're gonna grab the position, and position is the position of every little point being shaded on the sphere. We're going to add the time and position together. And then we plug that in just so we get movement here, but it's way too fast. So we can multiply the time. So we're gonna multiply this by some small values. We'll do like 0.025. And that's still pretty fast, but lets us see what's going on. So we'll keep it like that for now. So now you can see that we've got this moving fractal noise that's controlling the mixture of this sky blue and cloud color. So we're already getting something that's cloud-like. And if we go back with this movement and we control these parameters again, really just want to use these artistically and pick values that feel good to you and match your vision for what you're trying to create. So this is a pretty good start. But what we're going to do now is duplicate this noise. And we're going to multiply it by the original. And this new noise is going to modulate the original one. And we're going to use it to control the kind of macro level, larger swaths of sky and cloud. It's going to kind of let us determine a broader scale where there's clouds. And then this original node is going to control the look of the clouds within that. So to make this interesting, we're going to take the position and multiply by a different number. So if we were to just preview, let's convert this and put it directly into color so we can see what's going on here. This is our new second noise. And you can see that if we multiply it by something like 0.5, these swaths get larger. This will let us control where, broadly speaking, the sky is and clouds are. If we were to go the other direction, make these higher frequency, get something that looks more like this. But that is going to be more the domain of this original noise. That's where we're going to control those tighter frequency effects. So we're going to make this lower frequency. And now when we multiply these two things together, you can see, we'll bump up the amplitude actually on this a little bit. So that's gonna bring out, make these cloud areas pop a little bit more. But you'll notice that these regions are pretty static. And you can see this ridge here that's barely, it's not moving at all actually, because we're using time to control this original noise, but we're not using it at all up here. So we're gonna add the time to our noise up there. So now they're both moving. But I want this second noise we've created to move at a slightly different pace. So we're gonna multiply it. And let's make it half as fast. So now we have these big regions. It's gonna give us more areas of sky and cloud that are more distinct from each other. And then within those, we get all the movement from this original noise down here. So let's go back to our sky colors. And now we can see what's happening now that we've done all that. So looking pretty good. We can, if we want this to be a little bit more realistic, we could slow it down a bit more. And now we're really getting somewhere. So we've got these broader areas that are defined by this second noise. You could think of this almost like a mask for these macro level effects. And then we have this other noise that we created originally that is going to control what's happening within those regions. So if we mess with the octaves, we still have these broad areas of sky, and then we're controlling more of these finer grained effects that are happening within. And so there we go, some simple clouds in a Reality Composer Pro shader graph. Overall, pretty simple, pretty straightforward. You can mess with this all day and come up with completely different looks. Hopefully this shows you that creating these kind of effects in shader graph doesn't have to be super intimidating, and really you can treat it artistically and come up with anything you can imagine, really.